Hello, my name is Yusuf Alper Bilgin. I am going to present our paper titled as Cortex-M4 Optimizations for RMLWE, Ring and Module Learning with Error Schemes. This is a joint work with Erdem Alkım, Murat Cenk, and François Gerard. This presentation consists of four main sections, which are introduction, implementation details, results, and conclusion. In introduction, I will briefly talk about the NIST post-quantum standardization process, our target algorithms, and our target platform. In implementation details, I will explain our optimization techniques, which can be categorized as optimizations for speed, optimizations for stack usage, and optimizations for secret key size. Then I will share our results. Finally, I will conclude this presentation. NIST has initiated a standardization project for post-quantum algorithms, which include both key encapsulation mechanisms and digital signatures. The standardization project was started in 2016. The first round of the project took place mainly during 2018 and assessed different possible quantum-safe algorithms. There are five main categories, which are lattice-based, code-based, multivariate, symmetric-based, and others such as supersingular elliptic curve isogenies or zero-knowledge proofs. In the first round, the performance was not the main consideration, but instead NIST considered the security and cost as primary factors in its decision. In early 2019, 26 out of 64 initial algorithms advanced to the second round of the project. In the second round, it is stated that the practical performance of the candidates will play an important role in the selection for future standardization. This paper was accepted during the second round of the process. We aim to improve the practical performance of some lattice-based candidates, namely Kyber and NIMHOP, utilizing number theory transform for a faster polynomial multiplication. Recently, the second round of the evaluation was completed, and NIST announced the third round candidates, which contain four key encapsulation mechanisms and three digital signatures. In addition, five key encapsulation mechanisms and three digital signatures were also advanced to the next round as alternate candidates. Therefore, in total, there are nine key encapsulation mechanisms and six digital signatures. Now let me talk a bit about our target schemes for this work. The first one is Kyber. It is one of the third round finalists and fast almost in every platform. Its security is based on module learning with error problem. The polynomial multiplication is performed by using NTT, number theoretic transform. It uses 7-level NTT with Z3329x modulo x to the 256 plus 1. This ring does not fully split. We do not carry out the full NTT, but rather stop it before reaching the level of base field arithmetic. This also means that the coefficient-wise multiplications in NTT domain are done on small polynomials instead of integer coefficients. In this case, degree 2 small polynomials. These polynomial multiplications are performed with schoolbook method. The second one is NIMHOP. It was a promising candidate, but eliminated in the second round. Its security is based on ring learning with error problem. It utilizes 9 or 10 level full NTT with these two corresponding rings. The last one is NIMHOP Compact. It is a faster and smaller variant of NIMHOP. It was presented at LatinCrypt in 2019. Its security is based on ring learning with error problem. It uses 7-level NTT with these three different rings. As you may notice, these rings do not fully split. Hence, at the end, we have degree 4, 6, or 8 polynomials respectively. So we use schoolbook multiplications for these small polynomials. Now let me briefly explain one of the algorithms, NIMHOP. This is a high-level representation of NIMHOP public key encryption scheme, which is used to instantiate both CPA and CCA secure key encapsulation mechanisms. Please refer to the algorithm specification whose link is given below for full explanation. As you can see here, we have key generation, encryption, and decryption algorithms. We focus on polynomial multiplications in this work. In key generation, as you can see here, we have b equals to a dot s plus e. We utilize entity for a faster multiplication. This is also the public key b. Then this public key is used in encryption to encrypt the secret message nu. This encryption also includes polynomial multiplications at line 6 and 7. Finally, the ciphertext is decrypted by using the secret key S by performing this multiplication. Now let me talk about our target architecture, ARM Cortex-M4. It is NIST recommended platform for PQC evaluation. The Cortex-M4 is a 32-bit platform and implements the ARMv7 instruction set and provides special digital signal processing instructions. These instructions offer single instruction multiple data, SIMD, that can perform arithmetic operations on 2 half bytes or 4 bytes in parallel. This microcontroller has the advantage of having large enough memory to support public key algorithms while being still reasonably small and cheap in the grand scheme of computing. Its popularity led to the development of PQM4, a library aiming to offer a common framework for benchmarking implementations of post-quantum algorithms on this platform. This architecture comes with the restriction of a limited number of registers, which is 16 general purpose, 32-bit registers, out of which only 14 are available for the developer. In this slide, we list the previous optimizations of Kyber on Cortex-M4. Note that we also implement all of them. We use these techniques for NeoHop, NeoHop Compact, and also Kyber. Cortex-M4 is a 32-bit architecture, while the polynomial coefficients are below 16 bits. Therefore, in order to fully utilize the properties of the Cortex-M4 platform, we represent polynomials as an array composed of signed half words. We also pack 2 coefficients into 1 register. Thereby, we can utilize SIMD instructions and perform addition subtraction on 2 half words in parallel by using U@16 or U sub 16. Moreover, we implement a double butterfly, which takes a packed register as input and returns a packed butterfly result. We perform all computations in Montgomery domain, since it yields a fast Montgomery reduction, specifically after multiplication. We precompute all of trivial factors in the Montgomery domain and store them in flash memory. We reorder these constants before storing them in flash memory to have them appearing in memory in the same order as they are used during the computation. Hence, we can easily load the next one without computing its address. The load instruction on the Cortex-M4 has the ability to move the pointer to the next trivial factor while fetching the current value from memory. Thus, moving to the next factor has no extra cost. Link time optimization, FLTO, can give a performance boost, so we enable it. The critical performance gain with link time optimization is achieved from cross-module function inlining, which is not directly possible without FLTO. This will tend to increase the code size, since inlining functions across source files introduces code duplication. However, it should also be noted that link time optimization is more effective at identifying unused code or code that has no impact on the output. The Montgomery reduction on the left side is implemented in 3 clock cycles. In this work, we optimize the implementation of the Montgomery reduction such that it can be performed in only 2 clock cycles. We achieve this by storing minus q to the minus 1 instead of q to the minus 1 and using SMLABB signed multiply accumulate instruction, which multiplies 2 half words and adds the 32-bit result to another 32-bit value in one clock cycle. The Kyber implementation performs 3,200 Montgomery reductions in a full polynomial multiplications A dot B by using entity where A and B are polynomials in this range. Therefore, this change saves 3,200 clock cycles for a full polynomial multiplication. We also implemented a double Montgomery reduction on a packed argument. It is slightly faster, one cycle faster than the double Barrett reduction. Depending on the size of the modulus and the register size of the underlying architecture, it is not always necessary to reduce the results after an addition or subtraction. Skipping unnecessary reductions is called lazy reduction. It is common that optimized entity implementations heavily use this technique to speed up the code. However, those lazy reductions are mostly performed after an addition or subtraction. In this work, we also perform lazy reductions during component-wise multiplications. Here is an example. As you can see here, we can skip intermediate reductions, these two. We add a reduction to the end. And in fact, we lower the bound. While the bound for the first equation is minus 2q to 2q, the second one is only minus q to q. We save a lot of reductions by using this approach. You can see them here. We can also skip the Montgomery reductions after the multiplications in the first layer of the entity butterflies, where the inputs are polynomials with small coefficients that are sampled from the centered binomial distribution. In this work, we use 8 registers to keep 16 coefficients and perform 3 or 4 layers of the entity, depending on the distance between the coefficients being used in the same butterfly on the next layer. In other words, we load coefficients into these 8 registers in such a way that a maximum of entity layers can be performed before storing the result. Thanks to the structure of the entity used in NimHop and NimHop Compact, we can merge 4 layers since at some point we need coefficients with distance 1 and loading consecutive coefficients from the memory is free with LDR instructions. Now let's move on to the stack optimization. Entity is already stack friendly. It is entirely in place. We use these 2 previous optimizations. The first one is inline comparison in CCA decapsulation. CCA secure decapsulation first decrypts the ciphertext and then re-encrypts the obtained plaintext. This produces a ciphertext which is then compared to the original. Only if they are equal, the shared secret key is returned. This additional ciphertext is eliminated on the stack by inlining the comparison into encryption. Moreover, the matrix A is only required once for matrix vector multiplication and accumulation. The memory footprint can be reduced using an approach that reduces the storage requirements of A to only the state of the extendable output function at a time, allowing to generate a small number of coefficients for multiplication. So on the fly generation of matrix A in matrix vector multiplication. In this work, these methods are also implemented for NimHop and NimHop Compact. An optimization to reduce the stack usage of KeyGAN is presented here. Instead of computing the first equation, we compute the second one. Now let me explain the differences. Firstly, hat means that this value is in entity domain. We have already talked about A. We do not need all values of A. We can do on-the-fly multiplication. However, we need at least two polynomials on the RAM to compute the entity of S and E, secret term and the error term. For the second equation, we move the second entity here to the beginning. Therefore, and we add an inverse entity here. Therefore, we can calculate all operations by using only one polynomial at the stack, S here. Then we can do on-the-fly error addition and on-the-fly multiplication of A. At the cost of one inverse entity, the stack usage is decreased almost one polynomial. The last one is secret key size optimization. This is actually a well-known and obvious idea. There are different options. We can store the secret key in entity domain, which is currently used for Hyper and NeveHop. Or we can store only the 32-byte seed and rerun key generation during decapsulation. This can be preferred if the size of the secret key is really critical. However, it gives a significant performance penalty. A middle way could be storing secret key in normal domain. Another method could be storing only the 32-byte seed used to sample the secret key. We prefer the last one since our entity implementation is fast enough. This reduces the secret key size about 96%. But it has a drawback. It increases the decapsulation time by 7% for Kyber, 18% for NeveHop, and 9% for NeveHop Compact. This table represents our cycle count comparison. One can see that NeveHop and Kyber perform around 10% better with our optimizations. Furthermore, NeveHop Compact is more than 40% faster compared to NeveHop, and more than 25% faster compared to Kyber for all security levels. The stack usage comparison in bytes is given on this slide. Our results for NeveHop are almost half of the previous implementation. You also improve the stack usage for Kyber. In this slide, you can see the improvement on polynomial multiplication functions. It can be seen that Kyber and NeveHop Compact have similar performance, while NeveHop is slower. This is mainly due to the extra layers of the entity and the increased number of reductions caused by the larger modulus. It can also be seen that our implementation of the NeveHop entity is slightly slower compared to the previous implementation, while we have noticeably better performance for the inverse entity. To sum up, we propose various optimizations. The first one is more efficient modular reduction. We implemented a two-cycle Montgomery reduction, more aggressive layer merging. We merge up to four layers of entity by using registers carefully. More aggressive lazy reduction. We are lazy on the reductions even after multiplications. We optimize small degrees Kullback polynomial multiplications. We reduce the stack usage of key generation by adding the error term on the fly. We also give a trade-off between secret key size and decapsulation time. We give a unified framework to compare the three schemes, Kyber, NeveHop, and NeveHop Compact, as they use the same level of optimizations. Moreover, there are still some room for the improvement. One interesting point is that our entity implementation for NeveHop has slightly slower performance than the one reported in PQM4 before our commit. So using Gentleman Sunday might improve the performance with the cost of more trivial factors, storing more trivial factors. Moreover, representing coefficients as 32 byte signed integers instead of 16 bit might improve performance. By doing so, we can be more aggressive with the lazy reduction at the cost of using more registers. You can check our source code on this GitHub link. It is publicly available. We also commit our changes to PQM4. Thank you for listening.